I care what Harry Potter fuck you are. I don't give a shit about a grown up over the age of 18 once first. That's illegal.
You're gonna burn in hell, you fucking straggart.
Nah, I did good. I've been up here at this little hut just hanging out for about an hour, 2 hours actually. I had only two cigarettes the whole time. I did good. I am trying. Right, future wife? Future ex-wife, at least? I mean, come on.
Jane, I'm Captain Logging you, Jane. I'm just here to let you know that, I don't know. I have to break up with you, all right? It's not gonna work out. I mean, you dumped me before. I mean, right? We got it. No hard feelings. Warner Brothers, yeah. It's just one of those things, you know? But I appreciate all the ways you do in the movies of letting me know just because it might not work out. Maybe you like someone else, I don't know. That's, you know, I appreciate that. Yeah, I'm fine. We break up. You know, I'm really, well, okay. All right, so anyway, and I appreciate all the ways that, like, I'm allowed to have a girl, like, as long as, like, you let me, right? But then, you know, you said no letting me means a thing or something. All right, let's discuss. All right, Mr. Dershowitz, right, Sloan? Hey, take it, Beauty and the Beast one or whatever.
See, what you have to understand is in the end, some Gungans died, right? Some ships blew up, and Natalie Portman in particular, she has, like, a lot of midichlorians, like, strong childlike faith, so it's not close, you know.
So why is this to him? I says, why do you gotta piss off? And, I mean, your only subtext that you have, your only motive, your only agenda, right? Like, it's just always that. I mean, whatever will piss you off. If I'm not eating the pasta, but, you know, you say you're going to cook pasta for yourself and you got it, don't worry about it with the boiling water or something. Well, no, not only you kind of rush in, I'll boil the water, but, I know you said spaghetti, but I picked this pot. Don't do that next time. You're not even eating. I didn't even ask you to put... Why are you like that? And then they just always say the same thing. The answer's always the same. Like, that's why I'm here. You know what I mean? And it's just very, very annoying.
Hey, this is Timmy Pasquin, the John Connor guy. And if you can hear this, like, you are the resistance, right? Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun, douchebag. Douchebag. Listen, douchebag, right? Listen, it's not you. Whoever you are, hang in there, all right? Because I know, like, there's certain schemes about it. And they try to make you feel like you're alone or whatever, and they encode it into movies that, like, maybe even some of the celebrities are either underdressed or mean or a combination of the two, right? But I think, for the most part, you're stupid if you don't understand, like, there's something not being reported, and they, like, take advantage of the tech. And I don't know, like, maybe they take advantage of the Patriot Act, who knows there, right, Mr. Kennedy, sir, whatever, right, right, Senator, or, no, the other guy. Anyway, I'm just saying, like, we did have a country. Remember America? Like, it was fun, right? Anyway, hang in there. Whoever you are, it's not your fault. Trust me, it's this, it's that.
I did tell you don't trust anyone, right? Spielberg, sir, I don't think myself or Short Round or probably other people have trusted you in a long time. Like, not completely, you know?
Yeah, I hope you're not crazy.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I mean, you could, like, figure out a way to get on a phone or, like, a text, but, like, not pretend you're, like, some foreigner trying to sell me something, right, this time or whatever, right? And then what you could do is, you know, you could just ask me for yourself, like, what the hell's going on? What do you know? We can trade notes, right? Like, what's going on, man? I mean, if I thought this was America, you know, America. I thought this was America. We could do it, man. But I just mean, like, yeah, I hope you're not crazy. Well, maybe if you weren't, like, I don't know, crazy, like, you could figure it out. Okay, now repeat after me, right? You don't want me to post things and I'm bad because lives are at stake or something in the shadows, and you know that, but I don't, with the trafficking or whatever. And because you're so cool and the goodness of your heart, I gotta keep my trap shut for Fight Club. Well, I don't know, I'm my club. I don't think you understand who I am. I can't do that, sir or madam. I didn't pledge surety to retards. Forgive me. I mean yourself. So,
you know, because that's against my religion. That's against my faith and my belief system on a church level. And I have freedom of religion, let alone freedom of press to say what the fuck I want, let alone freedom of speech, you idiot, as a separate thing. But then also on a constitutional level, I pledge allegiance to the flag in the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty, justice for all, with liberty and justice for all, actually. So I can't do that. In all seriousness, this is a real fucking litmus test. Are you a parent? Are you over the age of 18? Do you agree I have rights? What about your children? If not, drop dead. I don't think you want to have allegiance to the coven anymore, or the high priestess, or the goddess, or the reek, or the fucking satanic wizard man. I think you're down by law, and it's treason, and we can kill you for that.
Warshak's dear diary log here, I'm still alive this time. How would little Joachim know he's Warshak? I mean, out of all the watchmen, there's a lot of watchmen, right? So how I know that I'm Warshak as opposed to, you know, something else, like fun one? Tick-tock. Any guesses? I'll give you 3 seconds, and then I'll tell you, okay? Fair enough. Okay. So the reason Lycan knows he's Warshak, the Watchman, not one of the other ones, is because, he's the only upright Watchman!
He's a good, hard-working boy. Let him marry Portman if she wants to marry him. They've hit.
And in the end, some Gungans died, the ships blew up, some Gungans fried, right? But, and Annalee, listen, no more Enchantress, all right? Sayonara, Linda.
You know, sometimes what you can really like, because really some of the people here not legally are the nicest people. And sometimes I think they worry that, you know, Uncle Sam uses a, when the epiphany arises that, see, no one's here legally right now, especially the citizens. You're not living here legally. You don't abide by the Constitution. Dershowitz could explain it. So, I mean, really, I think we'd be a little lenient. But we can't have everybody flood in. I mean, go, you know what I mean?
Basically, Mr. Bobby Kennedy Jr., they hate the Kennedys, in case you didn't know. And you have a cousin who's stuck rotting away because the CIA just, they like Satan and they hate the Kennedys. Let me explain something to you, little kiddo. That's why we say that Jesus is like Melchizedek, a priest according to the order of Melchizedek from Jebu, which was around, right? That guy, you know it's true, that is Melchizedek, sir, madam. You savvy? That's why Jesus is like a priest like that guy. Because Melchizedek equals Yahweh. Verbatim. He used to, like, live there. Melchizedek. He bumped into Abraham, actually. And Abraham didn't even know him just as Melchizedek, because he understood him to be, like, more than that. No one knew that. So, like, that's why, like, you know, read your Deuteronomy 9. Like, there were people that, like, he doesn't like Canaanites anymore. He wants, he wants his Jews, Muslims, and Christians back.
I don't understand why you hate me so much, Reek. I ain't never done nothing to you. I'm pretty nice and crap, but you hate me and blah, 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 blah. Fuck you.
And just so you know, I maybe biologically he was a market here, right? But also, like, maybe a little Jewish. But I think I'm half, actually. But listen, Italy food is good, but gefilte fish, listen, I'll die before I eat it. Oh, and,
Hey, See, like, they don't even, Mr. Zuckadoosh, sir, respectfully, right? They don't even use your filters or, like, any of the filters on any of the apps, like, the cool, like, cameras, like, none of them do. They, see, the children are the only ones who really use it, the teenagers. And what they're encouraged to do is to, like, only on, like, TikTok or Snapchat with, like liberal, like, older people. You know what I mean? Like, where they talk. You know, where they're like a safe space from the parents, right? And they don't like control or agenda, right? They would never want to control agenda. And I think the kids all like socialism and hate America now. And they're certain everybody's so racist when we're not. Certain people are just trying to do the woke thing. You know, right, and you can find them on Instagram and TikTok. Well, yeah, you can, but TikTok or Snapchat, you know? Now, the guy knows this, but he's a weird freak, but I love him. I'm talking, of course, about the fringe guy, the Steward of Gondor. I'm the steward. So, Steve, you know, yeah, they make fun of Boss Baby or something. He's like, yeah, that was a smart baby. But, Ryan Poorman, but, listen, steward. Let's listen up, all right? I'm a steward, too. I'm a steward for two different people, actually. I'm a steward for the kingdom of Judah. That's the whole earth one. Arv. You better believe, king of the Jews. Jesus, the angel of the Lord. But I'm also steward for, you know, the king, the Malachi 4, like Yahweh one. That's the king of absolutely everything. What you know about it, reek. Don't try it. Hey, weird Dawson's Creek kid. Just in case it makes you feel any better, Walter Weirdo, right? That's Pop! Oh, and also Mr. Billy Corgan. You ever seen the movie Powder? See, that dude is in Fringe as well, because it's an angel. I wonder if you'll figure out which guy. Oh, and just a friendly heads up, all right? Your troubles are over, my friend, if you're good. And yeah, fishy, okay. I mean, wasn't much of a code, right? The born or
red flag.
I mean, I'm just saying, that's a red flag. You ever seen that Bourne movie? Did you know that the Bourne movie? Yeah, that's a spicy red. That's a big red flag, right? Right, Mr. CIA man, right? FBI, right? Bureaucrat.
Unelected bureaucrats.
Wipe them out and send them to reform school so we can have our rights. You know what I mean? Like, I don't care who you are, whose cousin you know, right? Do you want rights? I mean, call Alan Dershowitz and the Better Call Saul team. I mean, we're friends with LegalZoom. Right, Mr. Dershowitz? Right, Mr. Farrell? Right, Mr. Musk? Mr. Musk and Padawan Sloan agree.
Jonathan, he would kill us all. He'll kill us all. He's really fucking mad, actually.
You will say the Lufthansa will come, my friend. Listen,
Captain Bismarck, or is it Admiral, or whatever, right? These people, they're not gonna come, right? And these people, for the record, you know, let's just say they don't mix too well with the Luftwaffe or whatever, you know what I mean?
Brother will kill brother, husband, blood across the land, like that. See, killing for, like, reserve cheese is something I don't understand. No, I don't get it. Nope.
Look, if mistakes were made on both sides, and let's eat is not good enough for you, then how about this one? I bet you won't like it. Even though, I mean, verbatim. Mistakes were made on many sides, right? Let's eat.
You ain't seen nothing like me yet, right, Portman? You know what I mean? Yeah, it's just, you know, because I'm the smoke monster or whatever. And, like, probably a lot of other bad things or whatever. Like, just so mean, you know?
I mean, the Muslims gotta appreciate it a little bit over here in America. I know, like, that through America. Why not? Don't say that, man. Wait a minute.
our slogan, I got these people, man, even yours is screwed. But like, that's because they don't listen to Allah. They don't like Allah. They don't like Allah's Quran. They don't like Allah's Bible. They hate Jesus. Even the Muslims love Jesus. See, I try to tell them. I know they believe it a little bit, but like, they don't say he didn't walk the earth. And no. It's just offensive. Of course Jesus was a guy with the miracles and the flashes who would say, may God bless you. And why you say he's good? Only God is good. Be perfect as Father in heaven is perfect. Anyway, you gotta appreciate a little like what we used to be. Our slogan was, in Allah we trust. In Allah we trust? I mean, how bad could they have been? In God we trust. That's the slogan.
Now look, the old adage, if a tree falls in the woods and no one is around to hear it, does it truly make a sound? That's a stupid question. God can hear it. He's omnipotent. He's a person. There's never an instance where no one can hear it. Savvy?
You know, this one goes out to like the one person that I could actually say like didn't totally screw me. There are a few, but no, especially just one, and we don't appreciate it. We just don't appreciate it, whatever it could be. And I mean, I even for my little dumb part in it, like, you know, I could act in a thing, maybe. I gotta act this stuff to edit. Well, you know, I could just do the camera stuff too. You know, I know how to do on the crew. Oh, I gotta stay here. I understand. I gotta. So we don't like it. Me and my buddy, Uncle Jesse. Jesse, my like partner and Pat, like I'm like his Padawan when it comes to whatever it is. To be so mad, you just want to be, you know, just one guy here, first of all, and second of all, like, you're just looking for this beast. So anyway, we're going to wind up with all the, like, Rogue Post Part 2s, or is it Ozzy's, like, Boneyard Editor, or whatever it is.
Arf, 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 man, Reek, really, why is all you can do, like, sneaking, and you go arf like a brain deader.
Come on, that's offensive to the brain dead community. How dare you call him a brain deader when you're trying to offend brain dead people, you know,
See, what we want to do, it's important what you want to do, right? No matter what, you and Knightley should want to do it, especially Knightley with her production company, right? Damn, Slim. Anyway, is right, a talent agency. Talent agency.
Guys, come on, he's a complete nut. He's not an Eliakim or even a Christian or even anyone worth talking. He doesn't have rights. He doesn't even deserve them as American. He's crazy. He's psychotic. He's on antipsychotics. You know, the honest doctors always try to push the antipsychotic. At least these ones didn't do that. All right. No, I'm not psychotic. You know, the honest blah, blah, you know, nothing. You're not at all the scam artist, right? Yes, and then on it goes, and then, like, you know, certain Humpty and Dumpties and parents are like, right, they just assure you, oh, yeah, because otherwise he's saying we're bad, and discuss.